Well, hello ladies and gentlemen. This is Mohit Pachisia, founder of Technically Sorted. And if you are new to this YouTube channel, go and press the subscribe button below. Check out the future videos and the past videos in the channel. You can also go to the description box and follow me on other various social media platforms. To know more about my paid courses, you can go to www.technicallysorted.com. So, let's begin. Why do I need trading psychology? Why does anybody need trading psychology? Now the thing is that especially if you are somebody who has some trading experience, you have seen how normally the new people who are not yet professional, not yet proficient in trading, don't have a trading skill and they go ahead and trade and they feel that the upheavals and the roller coaster of emotions of various kinds. And if you are absolutely new to trading, that means you are trying to gain the knowledge of trading. This is important for you to know, because when you are going to go ahead and perform on the trading screen, this knowledge will be very important to you. Now you see, it is very open and easy, accessible to open a trading account. It is not that much easy to get into those stature and stages of professional endeavor in case of other performance arts. Suppose I want to do heavy weight lifting. I can't really go to the Olympics overnight and say that, you know, I don't have the muscle power to do it, I don't have the training to do it, but please allow me to participate in the weightlifting competition. No, I can't do that. When it comes to training, it is very accessible. You are above the age of 18, you have got the necessary documents, and no matter how big or small the capital, just open an account and start trading. And this is where the problem happens, because most people don't take it very seriously. They don't think that trading is even a skill. They think, I just need to buy low and sell high, or sell high and buy low to cover and make a profit. And although this seems so logical, and it is, but the thing is, to be able to trade consistently, where you are taking out consistent money from the market in such a manner that you are able to pull that and withdraw that money out and put it in your bank account and spend that money and depend on that income to live, and not just to live, to create a fortune in fact. And that is all possible. It is possible to have a career in trading markets. It is possible to consistently trade. I have seen so many cases of even people who had these emotional upheavals before they started the trading career, or the beginning stages of their trading career, and you know, they really learned and they learned and they learned, and they were trained in a proper manner. Some of them I'm talking about my students only, and they changed the entire mindset towards the markets. Why this psychology and why this mindset is required, first of all, is because when you are trading, you have to align a number of things. The first thing you have to align is what is coming from outside the environment. So if you're an athlete, or if you're a singer, or if you're performing any kind of a task that is creative in nature, you will see that the pressure of performance is something which is natural. Especially in sports, which is very similar to trading, and I can draw out an analogy from, suppose somebody being a batsman who is playing as far as net practice is concerned, plays an over in net practice, the other member in the team throws the ball and he can hit, or she can hit, 6 sixes in 6 balls. And the same player, when it comes to the last over of the match, where the team needs about 20 runs to win and you have just 2 wickets left, the pressure is kind of very, very different. The margin of error is very, very small. A little bit here and there, you can lose the entire match or the entire tournament. And this is exactly how it is in trading. You see, the market, if I say the price is going to go from point A to point B, what happens is, I will see it as a space where, okay, I go long, and I say that point A is the point where I go long, and at point B, I want to sell. That is the place where I feel the market should go, for whatever analytical reasons that may be. There is always a chance that the price can go not just to point B, but to a point C, which is far beyond point B. There's always a chance the market can go to point B, but in between, towards point B, it actually topples from in between somewhere. There's also a chance that the market does not go to point B at all. Now, the whole idea about probabilities is not something which is which our minds are very used to, or our minds tend to like very much. The idea of risk comes with this idea of probability. And when I say risk, I mean volatility. I mean the way the market moves up and down. I mean when you have a position, regardless of what size of the position is. And of course, if it is a bigger position, then the higher level of volatility on the standing position. When this volatility comes in conjunction with the probabilistic nature of the market price movement, there are a whole host of emotions people tend to express on the screen. A whole host of emotions they tend to feel, and these upheavals of emotion, this roller coaster ride, tends to make them make a lot of mistakes. And these mistakes are basically human errors. Some very good analysts can actually go in the market and not make consistent money because he or she is not having the correct mindset to be able to handle the volatility and the probabilistic nature of the market. Now, how professional traders actually take out consistent money from the market is because their approach to trading is very, very different. Their approach to trading includes the fact that there are emotions present as a performer, as a trader, and those emotions are almost inevitable. They are almost inevitable no matter how big and how seasoned a trader you are. And the reason why these traders are seasoned traders, or any professional trader is a very successful trader, is because they took in these factors. They took into factor, took into account the fact that these emotions can come in between. And so, using the aspect of trading psychology, they helped themselves to make rules in their trading behavior that would limit these mistakes. Now, coming to a point where you actually make these rules and enact these rules is a very different thing. Talking about it is of course very easy. Reading about it is of course, YouTube video is also very easy. But when you actually go and express yourself in the market, things become challenging, things become different. And the intensity to which this can be different is very, very high. We as human beings, our minds hate probabilities. We want things which are certain. That is why you see maximum people are trying to run behind that ideal trading system, or ask people. I have got so many questions almost on daily basis. People ask me, is there any way to pull out this stock which is going to give this kind of movement on this day, on this hour? Is there a way to scan so many stocks and pull out which is going to act today, you know, where there's going to be action today, etc., etc.? There are endless questions trying to just get into a point where you're very, very certain about a move. Now, yes, according to the analysis you do, according to the homework you do, and if the market gives you those opportunities, these two things can come together. But what happens is that this entire approach from the very beginning is incorrect for most of the people. Most of the novice traders tend to look for these systems, tend to look for these scanners, tend to look for these strategies which seem like shortcuts and which are just nothing but a reflection of their desperate expectations from the market. Yes, that is the truth. Now, to come to a state of, and when your thinking is probability based, how can you actually extract the money? Is to first understand the nature of your psychology and the role it plays in trading, then make those rules, and then approach trading from a perspective which is probability based. So when I'm trading, I really do not look at the fact that is this one trade going to be right or wrong. It could be an excellent trade and it could go and hit the stop loss. Regardless of what it does, over a series of 10 or 20 trades, or over a series of say 5 to 10 market days, in the end I should come out in net profits. And each of my profiting trades should be substantially bigger than bigger profit than the losing trades. Those should be smaller losses. The frequency of my profits, that means the rate of my accuracy should be much higher compared to, you know, when I'm losing. So for example, if I take 20 trades, I should be making money in about 12 to 18 trades. depending on the market phase and depending on the size of the move, I also should have at least a risk to reward of 1:2, and which could run up to risk to rewards of 1:7, 8, 10, whatever it could be, again depending on the phase of the market. And when it comes to losing money, the amount of loss should be something which I can bear, something that does not hinder my emotional capacity to take the next trade. So if I have designed my rules, I have played by the rules of the market and the market price movement, I am a slave to the way the market moves, I can actually go and make consistent money in the markets. There were a lot of mistakes I also made when I started off. A lot of these mistakes were initially analytical mistakes, but later, even when I had done my analysis right, I could not get those results. For a very long time, I was struggling with my psychology. Later, when I started teaching people, I also realized that it is not very difficult for people to grasp the details of technical analysis if they really want to. Most people want to run behind these shortcuts, and really they don't work. If you understand the details, and then of course if you express yourself in a way which is not an emotional way of expressing yourself in the market, you can make consistent money. And this is why, you ladies and gentlemen, you need trading psychology. I'm going to be coming up with more videos and talking about the various smaller aspects, and one thing at a time. If you focus, if you study, if you learn, if you reflect, you can improve your trading psychology drastically. This will have a strong effect and strong impact on your profitability and consistency in trading. As traders, our goal is to have an equity curve which is relatively uptrending and smooth. If we are able to achieve that, then we have done our job well. So thank you, ladies and gentlemen, and I will see you in another video.